Thank you for watching Grampy's videos.
In this video, we're going to secure a basic wireless network and packet tracer. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to open up packet tracer, and then we're going to make sure that we're working from a new file. We're going to go to networking devices. Then we're going to click on wireless devices. And then we're going to insert a WRT300N. Next, on the wireless routers config tab, we're going to click on it once, and then we're going to go to the config tab, and then we're going to go down to the LAN connection, and we're going to change the IP address to 192.168.5.1, and then we're going to set the subnet mask to 255.255.255.0. And then we can close that. And then on the end devices, we're going to put a laptop on the working board. End devices, we're going to move a laptop up here. And on the laptop's physical, we're going to click on the laptop. We're going to come down here on the side, and we're going to put a wireless card in. So we first need to turn the laptop off. I'm going to zoom in. Now we're going to remove the laptop NM1CFE device. We're going to drag that over to the workspace here. So now we have a blank workspace. And then we're going to insert the WPC300N. So we're going to come over here and find the WPC300N. Put it into that slot, and now we have a wireless card with an antenna on it. Now we're going to turn our laptop back on. And now you see our wireless connection has been made between the wireless router and the laptop. Next, we're going to set up some security parameters on the wireless router. We're going to go back to the wireless router and click on it. We're going to go to the config tab and click on the wireless page. And on the wireless page here, we're going to select WPA2-PSK. And then we're going to set our PSK passphrase to Network Plus. We're also going to make sure that our encryption type is set to AES. Now, if you notice that we lost our wireless connection between our laptop and our router, and this happened because we changed our authentication method on our wireless router, but we have not changed that on the laptop. So now on the laptop, we're going to go to the config tab. We're going to go down to the wireless interface. We're going to select WPA2-PSK. We're going to put our passphrase in of Network Plus. We're going to make sure that our encryption type is set to AES. And if it does not reconnect, you need to troubleshoot it, but it should connect after a few seconds. And now we have a new connection between our laptop and our wireless router with the encryption. Now next, on our wireless router, we're going to click on that. And then we're going to go to our GUI tab. And we're going to go to the wireless page. And then we're going to go down here to the basic wireless settings. And we're going to change our SSID from default, and we're going to change that to Happy Vintage. Happy Vintage. And then we're going to scroll down, and we're going to save our settings. And if you'll notice on the left-hand side, we lost our connection again. And that is because our laptop is looking for an SSID of Happy Vintage, and it's currently set to default. So we're going to go ahead and close on, and now we're going to go back up to our page here, and we're going to go to security page, wireless security right here, and we're going to double check to make sure that we have WPA2 personal and AES and our passphrase of Network Plus. Next, what we're going to do is we're going to click on our laptop, and then we're going to go to our config page, and we're going to click on the wireless zero, and then we're going to correct our SSID, and that should be Happy Vintage. And if we wait a few seconds, we'll see the connection that comes back up. And then you can save this project for adding IoT devices, which I will have in the next video and in the next lab.
Thank you for watching Grampy's videos.